Hi, does the idea of self-care sound strange, selfish, or ridiculous to you? If the answer is no, you don't have to watch this video anymore. Otherwise, let me ask you a simple question. How well do you intentionally take care of yourself every day? If the answer is...
I haven't think about it in that way.
No, I'm not interested to think about it.
No, I don't have time for it.
Think again. I was just like that, under a pretty bad nervous breakdown. I was very unintentional about the daily life. I was just going with the flow. I didn't really care much about myself. So, if you don't like to have one, let's activate Mission Self-Care. The idea of this video came from my video creator friend Grace. I'm supposed to create a video showing a few self-care activities that I do in a day. As a matter of fact, I have been doing self-care intentionally ever since I started recovering from my breakdown. In this video, I will show you a few of those self-care activities that I try to do almost every day. Let's see. Number 1. Hit the bed early with less screen time right before sleep. To achieve this, I try to listen to an audiobook half an hour before getting to sleep.
Molecular biologists can now identify the microbe's closest relatives.
Number 2, track and maintain the quality and regularity of sleep. For this, I use an app called Sleep for Android. It can also be done with wearable tech. Number 3, do some stretches and mindfulness meditation right after waking up. Once I made this a habit, it became very hard to miss it. Number 4. Eat healthy food whenever possible. If I eat alone, I tend to choose healthy options, because on other occasions, the choices might be limited. Number 5. Limit the time spent on social media and the phone in general. I admit, this is very hard these days, but I use some apps to track my phone usage and to remind me when I am exceeding my own limits for each app. Number 6. Read a book for some time. This is the best self-care activity for the brain. Number 7. Exercise. I'm sure this doesn't need any explanation. In my experience, scheduling time for this in the calendar helps a lot. Number 8. Play some music and dance to it. I'm a bit shy sometimes, so I do this when I'm alone in my home. Number 9. Connect with nature. I just go out and take a walk in the park whenever I can. This elevates mood instantly and gives a feeling of freshness. Number 10. Journal thoughts, activities, and mood daily. Even when I miss other self-care activities in some days, this helps me to get back on track. So in my experience, this is the most important self-care activity, because it helps you to get connected with your own emotions, thoughts, and mood. And I manage to take corrective actions on them from time to time. This list is surely not a complete list. There are plenty of other things you can do for self-care. It's all about creating and following your own self-care plan. So my message to you is, if you haven't been caring yourself well enough, start now. It's never too late. It's good for you and everyone else. I thank you for your time and attention, and I sincerely hope that after watching this video, you will spend some time for your self-care. So my friend, if the last bit of your self-control is not taken by social media, resist the temptation to scroll down any further and start writing your self-care plan. Or take a break and start journaling. Till I see you again, take care.